Okay, now that I've managed to finish up writing the battle test, I now need to actually start writing some other software to make it easier to write basic programs. So, yeah, I guess I just need to get a couple of things set up here. This will only take a minute. Yeah, I need to get repo initialized for writing Python program. Okay, now copy that over there. Okay. Alright. So, here we have a basic program. Alright, this is just, you know, just one of the programs I use. I'm calling it test.bass because I'm going to be using this for testing purposes. Okay. Now, as you can see, it has line numbers, right? Now, I want to get rid of those line numbers to make it easier to program. Right. Now, there is... Okay. Right now, there is a program out there. Well, actually, there are multiple programs out there that can take basic programs that are written without line numbers that can renumber them, right? Alright, so I type in C64 list. We get C64 list. Okay. Yes, I'm going to. Right, C64 list converts the. Basically, can take a Commodore 64 basic program. And it can load that. As you can see down here, it has -LBL convert to label format, right? You can, with this program, you can write a program in a labeled format and it will add line numbers to it. But, right? So I'm just going to use C64 list as a way to label, to turn this particular test program into a labeled version, right? Okay, so when I open it up in here, that out. Now it is line numbered, right? It's instead of using line numbers, it uses labels, right? Labels. Yeah, now, the first thing with this really, though, is C64 list turns it into a labeled format, but I don't really like the way it formats it. Right, it uses a curly brace, colon, and then the label, and then another curly brace. I don't really like that. I want to use, for my program that I'm going to be writing, I want to use a different... Basically, I want to use a different... labeling method. Preferably a labeling method that is compatible with QBasic. Right? Okay. So... just wait a little bit here. Okay. Okay. Turn off. Okay, yeah, because I'm not in that for a while. Okay, now I'm gonna be writing this program in Python. So I just load up this. Okay. So yes, I'm going to be calling this program Basic Wrangler. Okay. So first I'm just going to put... Okay, so this is going to be a Python program. So first I'm going to put in a Python shebang. Change this to Python. Okay. So, Okay, and now I'm going to write. Now, this program here is going to be a program to fix the output. Okay, so fix the output from C64 list. So I'm just going to say, fix output.py fixes C64 list output for basic Wrangler, and then say C64 list, right, just give the bombing-odl, then fix output, then file name dot .odl. Okay. Block comment that. Step around here. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is grab. First thing I'm going to do, right, this is just a. Let me just change it to. Helper script that. Maybe that worked, yeah. Okay, so. File name equals sys.argv1. Means we need to import. No, just import sys, yeah. Okay, yeah. Okay, so yeah, we need. Right, so this is a really simple script here that will fix the output. Anyway. Yeah, okay, that's wrong. Fuck. Okay, that's wrong. Yeah. Okay, so let's say let's open our file, right? Open file name as put file, or is this file, input file equals file dot read lines. Okay. So that'll open our file. Right, I'm using read lines because it overall kind of just works better that way. Wow. So I know how to work read lines if nothing else, so. And say for index line in enumerate in a file. Okay. Yeah, I mean, now, I've never, before, in the past, I've used range, but since the last time I was really doing any programming in Python, I read that it's a good idea to use enumerate. So I'm not, I sort of know what I'm doing here, but not necessarily, right? Okay, so. So I'll do line equals line dot L strip. Okay, I'm doing line dot L strip as you get. You get all this kind of white space, right? You get a white space here, and I want to strip that out. Okay. So I'm just gonna, right, so I'm going to strip that. White space out. Yeah, again, I'm not sure if this is really gonna work. Maybe it works, maybe it doesn't, I'm not sure. we'll see, right? And line dot place, right? Say, oh no, wait, actually, that creates a deck. Okay. Line dot string, replace, yes, replace that. So replace the initial part of it with an at. Okay. Yeah, I mean, I want to have it set up so that you use at and then your label to designate labels. And at line.replace. And replace that with nothing. Replace the final curly brace with nothing. Okay. And I also need to import regular expression module. Right, and okay, actually, so I'll just okay. I'm gonna call, say, re quotes. Right, I need to replace something that isn't right. this regular expression right here is designed to it selects stuff that isn't in quotes. Okay. Right. Yeah, it's a little annoying, but yeah, but it's actually really important for what I'm doing here. Line equals three dot sub. Okay, and say, all right, now to replace rem, I just do rem plus re quotes, and place that with just replace that with a apostrophe. And then I can, right? And then I just do with open file name, and let's just slice it so it takes everything the last four characters, and then adds, it's called .lbn, so it can be used in batch files and the like. Open that for writing as file, and file dot write lines input file, and I save this as fix output dot py. Okay, so now I can just stage the change and initial commit added fix output helper script. Okay, now let's just see if this works at all, which is unlikely. Yes, let's see if this works. Probably not. Test.lvl. Invalid syntax. Oh yeah. So, okay, I'll just change this whole thing up a little bit here. Okay. So I'm just gonna change. Yeah. It's trying to be. Change that to say input file I equals input file. Okay, I'll just change. Yeah, I'll just change this. Or, no, wait. Did I just... Well, whatever. Oh. Okay. Well, whatever. That's from using index, aren't I? Okay. Finding place. Place. Index. So, yeah. Kind of messing that up, but whatever. Okay, that's... Okay, now this should work. Now, this one definitely will work, okay? Yeah, that was a bit of a... Okay, yeah, this will work. This should definitely work. Hopefully. Okay, so let's give this a try, right? S.lbl. Check that. And there we go. Now it works, right? So basically, it has now replaced the... So yes, now we've got all the rem statements have been replaced with apostrophes, and all the labels are now set up in the form way I want them to be, right? Okay, so now I need... Okay, so now I want to turn this... Let's just say I want to turn this... So I'm just going to add some extra stuff here, right? Just to make sure that the... Just to make sure that when I start writing the main program that the comment stripping works correctly. Ah, of course, here's an interesting thing. This is supposed to... This right here is supposed to be a capital, and this is supposed to be small letter. So, yeah. But, yeah, C64 list kind of messes that up. It outputs everything as capital letters, which is not ideal. I think I'm going to take that one and replace that. Just another test, right? On a go-to. Yeah, this is designed for testing, so. Right, yeah. That could say 930 at 930 990 at 1100 at 2480. Just keep adding some more of these, right? Just keep adding more labels in just for the testing purposes. Yeah, based on a previous attempt I made to write this program up, I seem to recall at go-tos having massive problems. As in, it just did not work at all, so. At 30, 1420, 1440. Yeah, this is just, I just want to make sure I have a nice long at go-to line here. That is 1550, 1560, 1620, 1630. And 1770, 1880. Yeah, I want to make sure these, even though this is just for testing purposes, I want to make sure that the lines are at least somewhat accurate anyway. 1980, 2090. at infinity at nice.
Yeah.
Okay, that's gonna be a lot. But yeah. 21. Yeah, I think that'll at this point. So yeah, that should be a long enough line to ensure that I don't have any more problems with this particular. So yeah, that should hopefully ensure that when I run, when I actually have the test, when I do testing on this, it won't totally. Yeah, that should be long enough, I think. So, save as. Yeah, I can oversave. Yes, I can. No, wait, close that. And okay, I can oversave that then. And so. Okay, well, actually, now I'm just going to come up with the, say, alt the best, alt the LBO, alt the L, all dot LBN dot git, and also save this as a git ignore, so I don't have to stare at those things being uncommitted. Okay. So now my. Okay, so now I've got a git ignore. Okay, so now I can actually start writing the main. Now that I've got the fixing thing done, now I can. Now I can actually start to write my main basic line number renumbering program. Okay. Basic Wrangler. A basic. A basic program reprocessor. Nice simple doc string there. Okay, so. Okay, so, okay, well. Okay, I know I'm gonna need sys, and I know I'm gonna need regular expressions. Okay, so maybe I should just start. Okay, so do say start just coming up with a couple of variables here. Paste. Right, I'm gonna have one thing which will allow for pasting stuff in pasting the output in emulators, and another mode for just outputting files. So I'm just gonna set. So that's one variable for that, and then another variable. Basic line length, well, maximum length of basic lines. I'm just going to use 0 for now, just as a placeholder. Okay, so now I'll just open. Oh yes. File name equals right now test.bass for now. So with open file name as file, say original file as file dot read. Still using read lines because. Basic. Oh, not just, well, BBC Basic, not just BBC Basic. Commodore Basic, BBC Basic, pretty much any kind of basically any kind of BASIC you could really want to use. What is it? like what I've got here with this particular test program is based off of something that was written the Amstrad. This is, I think, the Amstrad CPC version of a program. But yeah, I mean, this is designed for pretty much basically every version of BASIC I can think of, I can think of a lot of versions of BASIC. A lot of versions of BASIC. So let's try to. I probably should just set this up as. Maybe I will set this up. Maybe I'll set this particular. Set this up as a. Okay, first thing. Alright, so. When I take the. When I take the input BASIC file. So yeah, I'll take say remove comments commented. This will remove comments from the file. Alright, so this way I can remove all the rem statements and anything else that annoying things that might be there, right? Okay. Say for this line in enumerate commented. Say line dot. Find that strip. I hope this works. I hope that works anyway. Hopefully that works anyway. Or no. Let's change. We have to change that to commented index and then it's commented index. So this right here will strip out white space from beginning and end, including any new lines that exist. Now create a new list and for index line in enumerate commented. Say temp. That's true. Gotta copy that out of there. There, I think. I think they go there anyway. Okay. Sorry, quotes. Plus. Yeah. Okay, now this. I've tested this out with a regex tester, so it should hopefully remove anything that come. Should hopefully remove anything that's commented that has comments on it, I hope, anyway. Line. And then I'll just do uncomment.append temp. This is probably hideously bad, but whatever. I'm not going to say I'm a good program, good Python programmer. And no, commented list filter none uncommon. Then what is it doing there? Oh, okay. Yeah, it didn't have the bracket pair set up properly. Okay, return uncommented. Okay, and so then all I should then say working file equals remove comments. Then pass the original file to it. Maybe I'll just. Oh, that's true. Now that that's stripped. Let's do a final file equals slash n, right, join and working file. Then with open. File name plus. Actually, that's true. Just copy. That's true. I had that from the other file, so I'll just. But I'll do plus dash out dash bass. Okay, yeah. As file. Then file dot pipelines okay, I guess that'll work. I think that will work. Okay, so I'll commit this as initial comment stripping test. Now, okay. Oh, wait. Okay. Actually, so I don't need to open that. Join G. Oh, wait. Oh, okay. So that was just a typo on my part. Okay, so now I can open the output file. And so after V13, I had a comment there that it removed. And that randomization routine, not there. Okay, but, Oh, okay. Okay, but there's still a few more things. I'm gonna need to add a few more things to the stripping routine. Okay, so. Let me think of that. Okay, so... then maybe temp equals temp say r strip just strip off no way r strip colon and then also temp equals temp dot r strip another r strip. Okay, let's see if this works. Okay, so yeah, let's see if this works right. Trying to strip colons and spaces. And reload. Ooh, and it's stripped. Okay. Okay, so now I can... So I've managed to make this thing strip off all any comments and say... Oh, wait. Oh, I sure forgot about that. Oh, that's true. I should also... forgot about doing that. Yeah, so I also want to move some of these data statements around as well. So I got some data statements here, and I have some particular idea about a way to deal with the data statements, and so kind of make it to allow me. I have an idea for reformatting, but that kind of needs to move the from test file. Okay. Okay, so I've got my okay, so now I've got that. But okay, so now it will. Okay, so now I've got it set up so it can strip strip out the comments. Or at least the comments you don't want. So now I need to... Okay. Yeah, I've got a whole algorithm set up for this whole... for the renumbering routine, which is... really, really long, unfortunately. Yeah. Yeah, it's over. Yeah, it's over 60 lines. Yes, it's over 60 lines or whatever. So, and that's just of actual English text. So it's gonna be even worse in terms of this. Okay, so... maybe I should just... okay, so let me see. What do I need here? Okay. So... maybe I'll just... maybe the next thing I'll do is... let's just say... maybe I'll just, okay. Well, that's true. I need to have... oh, wait. That's another thing. Increment equals 1, just so I can... yeah. Yeah, I'm still trying. Okay, so yeah, I need to... okay, so my goal here basically is to create a pro... right. I want this program to be able to use whatever... to basically... I want to be able to have definitions of various versions of BASIC, right? So Commodore BASIC has one definition, BBC BASIC has another, etc. Zip line length, and then increments. So yeah, I'm just going to set up a definition. I'm going to set up any definitions I need essentially as a in function. Well, I'm going to set any definitions I need up as part of functions. Okay. So okay, so first I'll deal with the basic. So yeah, so first it needs to know if it's a case format, which we'll be brought in there. And then there's the basic line length. So I should probably just set something up here for say if case format is true and basic line length is 0, which is the default. Then say so the basic line length. So I set that to 72. I guess that's a bit better. Else no. LF not base format and basic line equals 0. Say equals 252. So yeah, I'll set that to 252, which is about as high as it can really go. Which is about, that's about as long as a basic line can realistically be if you combine those, right? And then we have combine. Set that to true for now. Maybe set. Space climbing for list mode. Set basic climbing for file mode. Okay, so yeah, one of the things I want this to be able to do is to also automatically combine lines. So you can write one statement on each line, but then it can combine all of those lines. Combine lines into really, really long basic lines. So I've got a whole algorithm for it, but whether to combine lines or not. And crunch. Say crunch equals 1 for now. Set the crunching level. Set the crunching level. Right? Say 1 is no spaces. 0 has spaces. So that'll remove space. So if it's at 1, it'll remove all the spaces from in between each statement. Now, some versions of BASIC you need to have spaces in between everything, others you don't. And I'll have print as question equals, let's say false for now. Right. Of course, this BASIC, right, this decides whether to abbreviate print as question mark, because a lot of them allow you to, instead of typing print, you can just type question mark. And do a statement joining character, which typically is a colon. I think there's only one version basically that doesn't use a colon. is the character that joins the humans together. And then say numbering equals 0, which is this is the number to start numbering with. Maybe, actually, just for the sake of future expansion. They'll also set numbering in there. I'll let myself pass that. Okay, maybe I'll just pass that on. So, okay. Maybe. Yeah, okay, so actually, I'll do that. If numbering is... Think, okay, what should I do here? Because, yeah, I want to make it so that you can pass a number. Maybe in future, it'll be possible. Right now, I'm just setting hard coding it as a variable, hard coding variables. So I'm thinking, yeah. Okay, it's greater than 0. Maybe, actually, sure, I can just do that, can I? Numbering, right? If numbering, or, okay, actually, I'll just make that an optional one, right? If not numbering, numbering equals 0. Okay, yeah, I think that'll work. Yeah, I think that'll work there, because that way I can just pass that on as a... Because that way I can pass that on as an optional. Yeah, because that way it's... What in the world? Unused variable. Of course it's unused right now. Okay. I'm also going to set one up for... Okay, case determines whether to change case on output usually blank. And yes, and then oh no, increment. Actually, sure, I can just set that as well. Actually, that's true. That's probably a better way to do it, really. Yeah. Just set that, right? And then also do a if not increment. Increment equals 0, increment is 1. This is the line numbering increment. And I'm also going to come up with something called abbreviate, which is currently set, which I'm setting by most of these to false. There's a couple, like, what is it? I know Atari Basic and TRS-80 Level 1 Basic both have this, the ability to abbreviate certain keywords, so. And then, so the whole point is this will tell it that, yes, you can, that the program can actually go through and abbreviate certain things. Yes, the use of an abbreviation dictionary. And then tokenize equals false for now. And this is to get the use of a tokenizer, which I'm probably not going to write myself, but other people might. So that's 1, 2. So that's a 10. Okay, so I'm just going to return those. Right. Return basic line length. Combine. Credits. Crunch. Print is question. Statement joining character. Numbering. Case. Increment. Then abbreviate and tokenize. Okay. Okay, so this right here is essentially a prototype for definitions. So yeah, it basically brings in, or no, wait. Actually, maybe I can change that as well. That's true. It's actually not a bad idea. Or no, wait. No, wait. Okay, I gotta look something up. Yeah, one of the things about me is, in fact, I've never really tried to use, in the past, I've never really bothered. In the past, I've never really bothered trying to use the whole use like Python like, asterisk args. So I have to learn what that. Okay. Yeah, this is something I've never really tried to do. Okay, yeah. Yes, and this is where the fact that I am really bad at Python programming is now certainly coming to light. Yeah, this is one thing I've never really properly, I've never learned how to do this. Okay. That's. Yeah. It's... Okay, maybe I'm just. Okay, I won't bother with that. Okay, I won't bother. Yeah, I'll have to try to learn how to. I'll have to learn how to do that at some later point in time, I think. Because otherwise I'll bore everyone to death. So, Yeah, I'll figure out how to fix that. I'll learn how to do that at some point. So yeah, okay. Yeah. Hopefully I won't have to change. Yeah, now basic line length. Maybe. Maybe I can just delete that. Okay, yeah, actually, sure. I can just delete. Or not delete that, but comment that one out anyway. Yeah. I don't know. That's the thing, I mean, the whole problem is I'm going to be, eventually I'm going to be copying and pasting this whole function, like, for every single version of BASIC I'll be using, and so, yeah, I mean, I don't want to get into this whole weird, you know, again, I don't want to be having to pretty much fix, say, 30 different definitions, so I kind of want to get this right at this point. I suppose it doesn't matter, but I suppose as of right now, I don't need to get it right. Basic line length, yeah, that's, yeah, if it's zero, which is the which will be pretty much the default if no one actually does anything. Okay, whatever. Okay, so I want to take. Oh, yeah, sure. Okay, so now that, so all of this will return a tuple, but tuples are annoying to deal with. So I'm going to import named tuple. Okay, this right here is definitely something I'm going to have to refresh my memory on a little bit. I know I've looked these up before, but I just need to remember precisely what I need to do to make this work. There's this whole. Okay. Okay, so say make this say basic devs equals named tuple and let's just say basic devs. Okay. And then okay, so now I have to turn this into a list. Yeah, this will let me take everything from there and then reference as a tuple, and reference everything with names, which will make it way easier than the way you normally have to do it, which is indexes. Okay. Then, so I can do can say basic diffs equals
basic devs. Test def. And then I put a test def basic format line, basic line length in there. Okay, now, basic defs, just test. Okay. Let's just see if this added test basic definition. And, it's true that gotta put an asterisk there to unpack that. I think I'm supposed to do that, right? Add an asterisk. Okay. Oh! Okay, and then, that gives me that. Okay! Okay, so, we got that thing. Okay, so name tuples aren't nearly as difficult as I thought they were. Okay, so now it basically brings in sets paste format, line length, file name, and then we've got our, right, opens the file, and then it, maybe I should also change that, right, to add another thing, right, basic type. Or maybe I shouldn't add that. Nah. Not yet, that's true. I'll add that function in later. Okay, so. Okay, so I've got my basic. So I've got my name tuple there. Then I've got my comment removal. Okay, so now I need to. So the next goal is to run through the program and basically pick out all the, Okay, so now my goal is to. Say populate label, populate label data. Working file. Okay, so I'll start my lines count at 0. Now for this line in enumerate working file. Okay, so line that starts with line that starts with at Oh, wait, okay. So, on of label dict is dict.
Okay,
line starts with at, say, label dict, then line, put that in there. I'll make that equal to zero so I can later add that in, right? Yeah, the whole point basically is the key is the label. Right, so the line number, the line starts with at, then that basic, right, that's the label, right? That basically means that it's a label definition, and so it can be brought in as the key, and then I'll just set the value to zero, which can then be changed later on, right? Line count. And say, then line count equals plus one. Length file equals length working file. Then just have to say total number of lines is length of lines in file minus line count.
Okay, so now I need to figure. Okay, so now I'm gonna go. Right, so okay, yeah. So I need to know the total number of. Okay, so based on the total number of lines, if it's less than 10, line, yeah, I need to figure out how many, like, essentially, how many, essentially, characters in a line that it should be taking up. Because, yeah, when I replace labels, can be all sorts of different lengths, so the goal is just to know, if I say, get and say at randomize, that's a lot of letters, but let's just say at randomize is say on line 3. But yeah, I kind of need to know, okay, how many characters should I make, just assume that that is, and I'm going to be very generous here. And I'm going to be extremely generous here. And, that'll be. I'm going to be extremely generous. And I'm just going to assume that I've got a lot more lines. So yeah, I'm trying to be somewhat generous here. Okay. Turn label dict line replacement. Okay. Function populates a database with labels and determines how many characters to assume when placing a line label. Okay.
So, I'll just try this. Alright. We'll populate my data. Working file. And then I'll try, say, print label depth. Print line replacement. Okay. Okay, so this is our added line or edit labeled dictionary routine. And okay. Three, which would make sense because this thing's only like this thing is in the hundreds of lines, so that works. And there we go with our label database. There's all the labels it found as it went through it, and it has a zero after all of them because it doesn't know what line number it would be at this point. Okay. Okay, so, I don't know. I haven't been at this that long right now, but I'm not really, I don't know, not feeling, honestly tonight I'm not feeling that good, and considering the fact that I've also, well, managed to run into a, actually I started to delete those now. Okay, so yeah, I think I'm about done for tonight. This hasn't been very long, but yeah, I don't. Honestly, though, yeah, tonight I just haven't been feeling that good, and since I'm kind of banging my head against it, I need to figure out how to conditionally how to deal with, like, you know, having stuff like the numbering and the increment and stuff like that. I need to figure out how to sort of, you know, conditionally bring that stuff in to basic definition. So, yeah, I guess that's it for tonight. So, thanks to whoever followed me, and, see you next time.